werewolf had met, and right now they're trying to trip her memory. And this is what happens during that process. For Parker, it started a few days after the raid with an ice cream cone. He and Melora had been roaming the city as usual. It was unseasonably hot, and Parker wanted something to cool him off. He spotted an ice cream stand. Turning to Melora, he said, "Come on, let's go get some ice cream." "Ice cream?" Melora said. "Yeah, you'll like it." The two of them approached the stand. The line was about 10 feet. Apparently, a lot of other people had the same idea as Parker. They finally reached the counter, and he bought two double-dip cones, chocolate for him and strawberry for Melora. Melora took a small bite out of the mound of ice cream. Her face lit up with pleasure. "It's good, yes," she said. Parker felt a kind of warmth flush through his body that had nothing to do with the day's heat. It pleased him that he had pleased her. He realized just how much his feelings about Melora had changed since the night he'd run her down with his car. Sure, he'd taken her in out of guilt. But he'd gotten to know her pretty well these last couple of weeks, or so he thought. And now he felt a deep fondness, like one feels towards a close friend. Even her bitchiness no longer fazed him. She opened her mouth for another bite. Parker laid a hand on her arm. "No, sweetheart," he said. "You're supposed to lick it. Like this." He ran his tongue along the side of his chocolate ice cream mouth. "It lasts longer that way." They started walking, too busy eating their treats to talk. After about a block, Parker looked up with his phone. Melora rarely spoke about herself or her home planet, and he figured the memories were too painful. Even so, ever since she came, he'd been curious about what life on an alien planet was like. "Should I?" he thought. Concern and curiosity warred within him until curiosity won out. "Hey, Melora, tell me if I'm out of line here, but what would you like as a kid?" Melora chuckled. "Truly." Parker laughed and believed that she didn't seem bothered by his question. "You sound like me. What'd you do?" "Stole me Falcha's flitter for happy ride. End up in lake." His eyes widened. Melora had told him a flitter was a two-seater air vehicle, sort of like a tiny car. "Darn, Melora, you could have died." "Almost did." He shook his head. "Ooh, so how old were you when you stole the flitter?" Melora didn't answer right away. She frowned as if trying to figure it out. 12, 13 year old years? Parker's estimation of her went up several notches. Stealing cars at 13, he'd never been so old. "I was troubled too, but we, my friend Frank and I, told you about him. We did stuff like playing dirty pranks on people and breaking into houses." Melora eyed him. "You get catch?" Parker grinned. "Once, almost. I talked our way out of it." They spent the rest of the afternoon regaling each other with tales from their misspent youth. It didn't surprise him to learn that Melora, along with the rest of her friends, it seemed, had been a daredevil, always game to pull off some dangerous stunt. Compared to her, he and Frank had been about as adventurous as a couple of toy poodles. Now, 3 days later, Parker felt as if he stood at the edge of a cliff. He and Melora lay side by side on the turf in his backyard, an empty bottle of Jack Daniels and an ashtray containing a half-smoked cigar lying nearby. Hand in hand, they watched the night sky. Or rather, Parker watched. Melora watched the sky. Parker's mind was elsewhere. "I'm an idiot," he thought. "Come on, Melora's an alien. She's been all over a galaxy, and I've only been to Canada. For God's sake, what do I have to offer her? I should just..." "What Sacklin is," Melora said, interrupting his thoughts. She pointed at one of the brighter stars in the west.